chairs go stage left.
Stage left?
Got it. Hold it.
What?
I said stage left.
Right.
No, left.
That's what I said.
You said right.
Because you said left.
Stage left.
This is left.
Right.
That's what I said.
No, you're putting them right.
Then what are you complaining about?
Stage right. You're putting them stage right.
Well, hold it, hold it. This is the stage, right?
No, this is stage right.
I need a map then. Where am I?
Center stage.
I know. In the center where we do all the shows.
But you're at center stage.
And the chairs go on the left?
They go stage left.
But I'm putting the chairs on the left of the stage.
But the left of the stage is not stage left.
You do it.
Fine.
This is right.
Left.
I mean, this is correct.
Now you got it.
But it's to the right.
You face out, idiot. Everything in the theater, all the directions are from the standpoint facing the audience. So, when they say, stage left.
Then they go over there.
Attaboy. Now can we get the rest of the chairs set up?
Sure. They're over here. Stage left.
What a crouton.
Where'd you park? Did anybody bring any donuts?
Donuts?
What? I didn't have time for dinner, and I could use a little energy food. I don't normally eat refined sugar, but in a pinch I'll make the sacrifice. Come on, does anyone have, like, a Snickers or Reese peanut butter cup? I will take anything.
How about 5 of them?
5 makes me sad.
I thought we were going to do one of the classics this go around. I should have known better. Do we ever do Tennessee Williams? No. Or O'Neill? No. Not even Shakespeare. Does anyone here ever read? Every time, it's something like, only gets a rash, or not with my armadillo, you don't. Who chooses these things?
Hey guys, I have a wonderful idea for the show. Let's do it as a dinner theater. Well, we can set up tables in the lobby and out in front of the theater. Well, you know, al fresco. With umbrellas under the tables and little ones in the drinks. Well, that way we can save more money at Schultz by buying cheap chickens.
My mother said I'd have to be home by 10, and no ifs, ands, or buts. And that includes all rehearsals. I can go 10:30 on show nights, but that's about all. I don't really think she trusts me. Okay, well, there was that one time that I didn't come home for 3 days, but that's because I have a life too, you know? Anyway, it was an emergency. I thought I was getting married.
Earlier, I thought it was a food.
Do you understand anything?
Nope.
Okay, everyone, the show calls for cast of 15. We'll have a moment at 4 o'clock.
Ooh! I want to play a man this time, okay?
Pardon me. What? Is this where auditions are being held? I'm new here.
New? She is new.
And different.
Let's burn her at the stake. Name? Darla?
Last name?
Gunglefinger?
No, it's really.
Really?
Gunglefinger?
That sounds like a candy bar.
To you, everything sounds like a candy bar.
This is the place, huh? She works with me down at the soap factory.
I'm in leather.
Me too.
I've always heard about your group here, and it always sounds like fun.
Can you afford signatures?
She could always try the Carousel Community Theater. Come on, man, that's cool.
Carousel Community Theater for event.
Our rivals.
Our worst enemy. And they do better shows than we do.
That's what you found.
Have you ever done anything on stage before?
In front of an audience?
What is it with you, Helen? Someone drop a house on your sister?
Do you mind?
Well, I've done a few things.
A few things? She's quite a wicked ass understudy.
So, naturally, she works in a soap factory.
It's one of the better smelling factories. I'll be glad to fill out a questionnaire and give you a resume, fingerprints.
That's not necessary.
How about a phone number?
You know, I do have one question.
What?
Do they still use horses to make soap?
No.
You'll have to forgive him, Dio. He was one his parents were expecting a human.
Shut up, Tina. Hey, get up. Where'd you get that chair?
The Pope? Well, since they canceled his audience.
Okay, does anyone have anything prepared?
You said we didn't have to have anything.
And you don't, do you?
No.
So what are you complaining about?
I'm not.
Okay, Darla, why do you want to be on our show?
Do you date co-actors?
Smoothies.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Wow. You just told a little old director one of your little old heart desires.
Bachelor number one comes from a state of desperation. His hobbies include breathing heavily and writing his phone number on bathroom walls.
But don't you worry, ladies, because he'll take a fax number if you don't want to give out your phone number.
All right, everyone, give Darla some room.
You are the lady. Uncle Morton is senior. Move along.
You want to be on stage because... Well, it's the only show in town. I mean, when you think about it, it's not something you have to think about. You simply want to act. Get up on some dark stage, pretending to be somebody you're not in front of a crowd full of strangers. Saying a bunch of lines you probably don't understand. As odd as that may sound, it makes you happy. Like I said, it's the only show in town.
I like belonging to the group. In high school, I was never really part of a group, part of anything. But here, I know everybody and they know me. Even when we get new people, I know they're a lot like me. You know, a common bond. Yeah. We're all a part of it. The group. Made up mostly of people who couldn't get into any other group. Wait, can I start over? I guess not.
I'm here mainly because, well, I came down to pick Ace up from practice one time, and the next thing I knew, I was in the opening scene. I was originally looking for a class on welding. I don't know if I'm a good actor, but I still can't weld to save my life.
It keeps me from eating.
That's good. Yeah.
Usually.
Well, I read the story one time in People magazine about somebody, I don't remember who it was, and how she didn't have much self-confidence. So she took a chance and she joined a group. I don't remember where, and that really seemed to help her. Well, now she's won all sorts of awards. I don't remember which one. And is happily to be married to... Oh, what's his name?
I saw an ad. You know the one. Talking about auditions for a play here. I thought, I'll give it a whirl. See if I had any of those creative instincts I mentioned. Find out if I had a lift to dig into my inner soul and find a spark of untapped talent. But really, I auditioned to meet new friends. Boyfriends in particular. It was either this or take that welding class.
Of course.
course.
Sir Harry! Oh, how we all loved putting him to bed at night.
It's gonna be a coin toss on this one.
Say that.
It's a little confusing.
It's supposed to be. That's where the conflict comes from.
You want conflict? Try surviving into staying without melting.
We'll get a letter key. Thank you.
But is it supposed to be confusing this early in the show?
Look, we're trying to fool the audience here, and at the same time, start the clock. You have to make a big to-do about the clock. Here's where the clock starts, and it has to sound confusing.
Gracie?
Yeah. I just got a phone call from somebody.
Who?
Well, they said I should tell JB that the backer will be in the audience opening night.
What?
Backer?
There's nobody here named JB. Well, that's what I said, but they told me to post a note anyways.
But we're already opening.
Wait just a same job minute there, Scarlett. You mean a backer wants to see this show?
It's probably a prank.
But that means they want to put money in the show.
Then do what?
Nothing. It was just a note.
We better be better and fast.
Oh no, don't start this. All we need is a bunch of false rumors going around.
Hey, it might be a real rumor.
What's the scene here, folks? A backer is coming to see the show.
You mean somebody actually wants to take Hark Hark the Dumplings on tour?
Nobody said anything about a tour. It's just a note.
To JD.
Who's JD?
Nobody.
Nobody? Nobody gets a note around here?
No one gets more mail than I do.
Or she does.
Oh, that's right. It could be a she.
So she has a backer coming to take the show on tour?
Or maybe even further.
What do you mean?
Maybe she could take it to the Great White Whale.
This from the Great White Whale. Mm-hmm. Okay, so what's JD stand for?
Juvenile delinquent?
Junior development?
Jack Daniels.
Of course.
Hey, I'm going to college. Come and play.
Did you guys hear?
What?
Nothing!
We're going to Broadway!
When you stop, all we have is one note of somebody nobody knows to somebody else nobody's ever heard of. And look at you, flying off in all directions. You people are the worst guys ever.
She started it!
Yeah, all
should have just given you the note first, shouldn't I? That's right. Sorry. It's okay. By the way, you told me to remind you when it's time to take your pill. Oh, that's right. I broke up your lines. You're back.
Pill?
She's taking pills?
What to what for?
You know, she has been looking a bit pale lately.
Oh, well, vampires look like that.
It's probably for her blood pressure.
You think?
Well, yeah. You ever notice how much she gives me a direction? That thing in your neck sticks out of the back?
Yeah.
It looks like the Mississippi River. I bet that means heart problems.
She has heart problems?
That must be it! She keeps saying that this is going to be her last show. What if she means this is her last show?
Wait, everyone give up smoking today? Gracie, are you alright?
Had any fainting spells?
Well, do you want to lie down with me?
But what is it now? Oh wait, the pills.
It's okay. We understand.
Do you need someone to drive you home?
Hey, I like the jewels.
There's the bulletin.
I've had to take pills before.
What a revelation.
It's nothing. It's just, we'll go back to the room at the back.
Oh, right. We're going to Broadway.
I don't be saying we made it with talent like, well, me. You're so modest. Well, sincerity, that's the key. Fake that, you can fake just about anything.
Can we get back to rehearsing now, please?
What are you guys talking about?
A backer's coming to take the show to New York. We got a note.
We didn't get a note. It was for someone named JD.
JD? Oh, that's Darla.
Yeah.
You're JD!
Now it's a Greek chorus. Jeanette Darla, that's my name.
We call her JD down at the factory.
You got a note about a backer coming to opening night.
Yeah, tell us all about it.
A backer? He must have said a packer. Max, down at the factory, he works in packing. He probably called. He's a packer.
See, what did I tell you?
We were so close.
Yeah, just a few phone calls away. Okay, now, let's get back to rehearsing.
What for? We're not going anywhere.
Oh, everyone, take a 10-minute break.
I just wanted to go to Broadway!
We don't have a pack.
packing section down at the factory, so how did you call Packer?
I don't.
Then, if that call wasn't from Packer, it really was from my brother.
Never mind the struggle, we're all doing something.
Just one.
It's one.
We'll do whatever we can to help.
Yeah, we're already in a lineup.
Are you the one in charge here?
That would be Gracie.
Hey! She's not here right now, but she's not here, I'm in charge. Remember?
I thought you gave her money.
You are?
Lucille Bob Classic. You can ask me anything you need to know. People ask me all sorts of questions around here.
Yeah, like, how are you?
Will you move your car?
Who gets it?
Are you gonna be in there all day?
Yes.
Look, we got a tip that the notorious criminal, wanted by the FBI, might be pursuing for all paths. Used to be an actress, can't seem to keep away from the stage, that sort of thing.
And you think she's here?
So we're checking all the theaters in the area. Her name is Phoebe Titchwell.
There's no one here by that name.
Don't be too sure, Missy. She probably isn't really.
What does she look like?
Well, that's probably
that bad.
We just don't have a good picture. You see, she's a master of disguise. A clutch devil she is. She can make herself look very young or very old. Taller or even shorter. She can be posing as a man, wearing a beard, or walking with a limp. In short, she can be anybody, anywhere.
And how do you know when you catch her?
Well, she has one fault, something that should take us right through. Whenever she gets on stage, she forgets the line.
She has to rest us all.
That's it. That's all you have?
One more thing.
And that is?
I'll tell you. She's allergic to roses. Anybody been sneezing lately?
But what's she wanted for?
Murder. She's a pretty desperate member, all right. But if I were you, I'd keep your eyes out, your ears open. She may be right under your very own nose.
You don't need a detective. You need an ear, nose, and cloak guy.
Hey, everyone! Look what someone just sent me! Roses!
They don't bother you?
No.
May I?
Okay, but remember where you got them. Who is this guy anyway? And what does he want with my flowers? He's an investigator. I can steal those. Just one second.
Well, no reaction so far.
What's he looking for? To see if anybody's allergic to the roses. Well, it won't work with those.
Why not?
They're plastic.
Here.
What's going on? We're just doing a play, right? A farce, not a mystery.
It may have started out as a farce, but now it's a mystery.
And yawn. And now, having the wherewithal, seek the whereabouts of my ne'er-do-well's nephew, who wears on my whatever. So hereafter I shall seek whereafter, for who after is after my whatever. This place stinks.
Hold it! Everyone, back out here!
Well, it does. And I want you to put a sign out the lobby. Please don't shoot the actors. It's not their fault.
Who asked you? And where is your voice?
I swallowed it.
No, I mean your accent. You said you're going to work on your accent.
I'm not ready yet. Give me a break. And you were going to have a coach come in and work with us, remember?
Hey, be nice. She's not feeling well, you know.
I feel fine. That's all the records lately over how I'm feeling. Last night, John brought me some chicken soup. And tonight, I got an industrial-sized bottle of aspirin on my clipboard. Oh, and who left that hospital brochure?
Pixies.
Very rude.
And generally dressed like us.
I feel fine, right?
It's her blood pressure.
It's not my blood pressure.
Do you want to lie down?
If somebody asks that one more time.
Do I have this on right?
I think I need to lay down.
That depends. What are you?
I'm not quite sure.
You look like a sideshow.
Yeah. Half man, half patio furniture.
Well, I haven't quite got it yet.
There.
There? It looks like he's gonna go to some kind of wine rodeo.
Yippee-ki-yay, Donna.
This is by far the strangest show you've ever done.
Wait till you see Act 2.
What is it, Martin?
Mr. Havishaw's backstage.
The owner of the building?
He wants to know if it's safe to come out here.
He's afraid of us?
Oh yeah. Remember last time he came out on stage and you guys were doing West Side Story?
Oh yeah. It was during the knife fight.
Well, I thought he did alright for a man his age. Yeah, considering he didn't have a knife.
I think he was mostly scared of the dancers.
Mr. Havishaw?
Hello?
You can come out here. It's safe.
You sure? Well, I've got more insurance now.
We're all quite harmless.
But then why is the terrorist here?
Just drop. Hey, I'm responsible for that. What can I do, sir?
Well, I hate to intrude. I guess you're all busy, but something has come up that I feel should be brought to your attention.
I'm all ears. Everybody in the class.
Dressed like this?
You and I should be.
Now, what is it?
Well, the thing is, I'm selling the theater.
What?
Selling the theater? Did you hear that?
What?
He's selling the theater.
Selling the theater?
Who is?
He is.
Who's he?
He owns the place.
He's doing what?
Selling the theater.
Selling the theater? Gracie, did you hear that? This man's selling the theater.
Well, that was not wrong fast. Mr. Havishaw, you're selling the theater?
Well, it didn't sound as bad when I said it.
But what did you do?
I have a buyer. He wants to start a cable show. He wants to start a home shopping program. Of course, this theater would be perfect for that kind of operation. Cameras, microphones.
But when?
Well, immediately. And that's why I took a chance on coming out here on stage.
Good evening, Ms. Webster.
Yeah, what's shaking?
What's going on?
He is selling the theater.
Selling the theater?
Will you stop?
So you're gonna have to cancel the show.
Cancel the show?
He wants us to cancel the show?
Why does everybody repeat everything I say?
We can't cancel the show. The show must go on.
Thank you, Casey Barna. Mr. Havishaw, is there something I can say, something I can do to make him change your mind?
I hope this isn't bad news for you, Ms. Holmes.
Mr. Havishaw, can we make some sort of arrangements? Can we talk this over?
Well, I guess we can talk about it.
You and who?
Oh, maybe you.
You!
Representative?
I think that would work out swell.
Why, Havishaw, how do you talk?
That's your accent.
I shall come back after rehearsal is over, if that's okay with you, Miss Holmes.
Swell. A fine plan. I'm sure you two can work something out.
Host it. Until then, Miss Holmes.
I shall count the minutes.
One Mississippi, two Mississippi.
Bye-bye.
Toodles. Things I do for the theater.
What are you wearing?
No, he's always not the last menu.
Really? Yeah, you might need this.
Now, what's all this about stopping the show?
Nothing.
Wait a minute. You know something. Hey, Gracie, he knows something. You know something.
No, not really. Just an only.
Only what?
Nothing.
Cal?
Cal, what is it?
Well, you remember back when we had the first rehearsal, somebody left an emergency exam in the back of the school to open it, and thought someone was impeccable. It turns out that that's not impeccable, or y'all thought it was in the first place.
Do you scuba dive?
So you really do go back to the show?
Stop! I can't believe you people! This place is nothing but a bad fantasy, isn't it? First, we have the rumor going around saying that some big-time producer's gonna take us all in New York, and then we have the one going around gonna say that at death's door!
Don't forget the murderer.
And then when the guy shows up here, by the way, hey, that's right, he was sick.
Do you need to lie down?
Some guy who doesn't show you any of his credentials says that he's a policeman looking for a wanted criminal, a murderer, no less, and the only thing he knows about this murderer is that he or she is allergic to roses.
It could happen. What? You never watched CSI?
That's it! Look, I want you to forget about all the rumors and just focus on doing this show. I don't want anybody thinking about any Broadway openings, and I don't want anybody trying to figure out how to fingerprint anybody. Oh, and I don't want anybody. You hear me? Anybody. I feel ever again. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
I didn't hear you.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Now go backstage for the next 10 minutes and go over your lines. While Dina and I try to figure out how strong the reaction of the sun in this place. Is that clear?
Yes.
Thank you. And now you don't mind going out of David's power shot, do you? Oh, you are asking. Look, just figure out the details and then get back to me. If anyone can stop Mr. Havishock to sell this place, you can. Besides, it'll get something else for everyone to talk about besides a murder, quite at least in the theater. One of these days, I'm going to get a social life. But for now.
I hope you don't mind. I brought along a little peace offering. These are for you.
For little old me? Why, Mr. Havishaw, you shouldn't have. This is ever so nice. Why, they're lovely. Here, let's go backstage and get these in some water.
Yes, whatever you say, my dear.
Yeah, something else for everyone to talk about besides a murderer with allergies running loose in the theater.
Or does he have to raise money from other investors?
And is he talking about Broadway or not?
Would he like to date older women?
What?
I've been trying to get my mother out of the house.
Why did you make up a story about him not being a producer?
Yeah, don't you like us?
I wish you'd just forget you ever heard about him.
That is true.
He really is a producer.
Hi, guys.
Cal?
Uh-oh.
Just a minute.
Wait.
What kind of plans?
Our parts. We have to make sure we have enough gold.
And it wouldn't hurt if they were bigger.
What do you mean? Add lines?
Well, who's gonna know the difference? This place is big as hell.
Yeah, anybody can write this kind of stuff.
Has anybody seen Gracie?
Not yet. You know, I always thought my character could use more passion.
What passion? You play a horse.
Well, I mean, just a run and I'm playing a bad game.
Has anybody seen Mr. Havishaw?
Who cares about him?
Yeah, let him get his own agents. Hey, agents! Are we all going to need agents now?
And where do you find one?
I think they hang around pool halls.
How do you figure that?
Well, you have to make money somehow.
Not pool halls, you idiots.
Pools. They hang around swimming pools.
If Mr. Havishaw closes the theater,
he's not. Dina's a pair of rats.
Will you stop talking about murders? This is important.
Can I borrow somebody's lipstick?
I couldn't help myself!
Yeah, are you trying to help me?
So, how are we gonna recognize that guy?
Sir. too now, you know.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Starlet is.
So she know what he looks like.
You're starting to pay attention now, are you?
I didn't really tell them anything.
Stop talking back when you did tell them.
Hey, there she is. Oh no, make her tell.
Well, I guess you are. And you've really been working on it, haven't you?
Yeah, they're really on their toes when I'm around.
What about those quick entrances and exits in it? How's that coming along?
Well, it's...
Thank you.
that. I don't know what it requires. Layers on my whatever.
Whatever. Why do I have to do this part?
Look, you're the only one left, and no one's heard from Gina. She's not answering any of my calls.
Why don't I turn her into the police? And when they find her, she can do the part.
Look, you're doing your part. We open in 3 days, and it's as simple as that.
What if somebody murders me?
Then you want to do the part.
This is a sudden line to
have. Look, forget about that stupid rumor.
Tell him.
Sergeant Hawk,
I told him they've met.
Yes, I'm Sergeant Hawk.
What can I do for you?
I have some news from the federal authorities that the killer is in your group, and somebody may be murdered.
What were you saying?
Sergeant, if you know this, you must know who the murderer is.
Right now, it could be anybody.
Well, don't look at me. Killer needs a motive, doesn't he?
Yeah. How do you feel about the act force?
Oh, well, I like to kill... never mind.
I keep an eye on that, how are you?
Sergeant, if you don't know who the murderer is...
Dina, what she looks like.
Dina.
Or where she is.
Dina's house.
What was that mean?
I said...
she knows nothing.
What's the name of the act?
Act 1 or Act 2. Yeah.
I just want you to know, we'll be here opening night. That's when she uses these tricks.
An opening night?
That way, she always gets in the headlines. Don't worry, I'll be up back. My men will be up front.
Do any of them want a part in this play?
Won't be necessary. Same with me, night.
This is getting ridiculous. A killer that's going to commit a murder on opening night, this is just melodramatic.
Well, I'm starting to get scared. I mean, or melodramatic. I can't tell the difference.
Well, what am I supposed to do?
What if we just start on the second night?
That makes the second night opening night, dummy.
This is getting tricky.
Hey, Gracie, how's your head?
Still attached to that chicken on Friday.
It's just that, well, you heard about the backer coming and all. I didn't really want that to get out, and I'm sorry for all the trouble it's caused.
A little late for that now.
Anyway, he is coming to the show.
He is?
I better warn these lines.
Oh, well, there's an idea.
Well, that means if the note was true, he'll be here on opening night. That's right, but don't worry, no one knows except for me.
Opening night.
I'll introduce him to you after the show. He'll be in disguise.
In disguise.
That's so Dina can't murder.
Will you stop saying that? There's no killer in this group, I'm telling you.
Me? You're the one that said she's the killer.
All I said was I thought she might be the killer because she sneezed at the roses, and that's all we have.
Then Mr. Habershaw disappears.
Well, we need to be taking a nap somewhere.
Can I interject?
What is it?
Phone call just came in from some secretary or other. Said they wanted tickets for her boss.
So?
Well, it seems that he, her boss, is the guy who wants to buy theater from Habershaw. And since he can't get Habershaw on the phone, the guy that is her boss, that is the secretary's
what
boss.
What does I want?
I'm trying to tell you. He said, well, his secretary said.
My ring.
The buyer's coming to the show.
When? Let me guess. Opening night.
Well, if you knew that, then why'd you make me go on?
Have you kept track of all this?
Well, as near as I get it, if we don't do the show, the backer won't see it, put any money into it, and the killer will never be caught. But if we do the show, then the backer may see it and want to invest in the show. The buyer's going to want to take over the theater from Habershaw, and somebody's going to wind up dead.
That's about it.
Except,
if we do the show, we might catch a killer.
If the police are fast enough.
And catch her again.
Which means,
if somebody gets killed...
Holy!
Will you stop? Look,
we have any ideas?
What if we just start over with... what if we just got Act 2?
No, we've got to keep going. There's no killer, I'm telling you.
You really believe that?
Oh, here, just go back and go over your lines, but this time without a script.
Gracie?
Yeah?
Starting to believe me yet?
I think so. You want to get a burger?
Yes.
Gracie sent me. should spin first and then heel click.
I like that way better.
You're right, she's an idiot.
Does anyone see my pants? Match?
That was hard to hop. Well, let's go find him.
Okay. Good.
Wait, you said
back.
But what if she gets back before you do?
You're on your own.
I'm not very good on my own.
Did they come through here?
Who?
Anybody.
They went this way and that way. Wait. We go that way.
I go this way.
Then, when I came here the other night and Darla saw me, well, I knew I had to come up with something else, so I
blackmailed me into a date.
Yeah, but you had fun.
Look, everyone, it's all over. You're not relaxed.
Wait, has anybody seen Mr. Lavender?
In the bathroom?
Yeah, he should have been here by now.
Yeah.
I think he left.
What?
Yeah, some guy in a dark suit said something about this being a madhouse when I was sick of getting pushed in and out of doors.